We as a society in the US are spending $10 billion, with a B, dollars a year on the issue of wildlife vehicle collisions.
DOT is a transportation agency for sure, but we're also part of a state government that values quality of life. It's not as simple as it puts the pavement on the road, right? There's more to, you know, what our involvement is with what everybody cares about.
Here at NYSET, we have an environmental ethic that runs throughout. It's even in our mission statement, you know, transportation in an environmentally sound manner. And I really take that to heart.
This is our backyard. This is our landscape. We want it to be resilient for our current generation and features of people and wildlife to really enjoy what it is like living here in the Northeast.
So I think there are, you know, multiple benefits from incorporating larger structures and trying to better accommodate wildlife crossings. We want to get as much benefit for the investment that we're doing as we can. And if that benefit is both, you know, serving the road and the environment that it goes through, then that's a win-win.
Hi, I'm Jim Andrews, a herpetologist and road ecologist from Vermont. I've been asked to help share with you what transportation and wildlife professionals in the northeastern U.S. are doing to minimize the impact of transportation infrastructure on wildlife and ecosystems and improve motorist safety.
Sure, yeah, this particular location is in Royalston, Massachusetts. On
over the summer and fall, we've spoken with nearly 100 engineers, wildlife specialists, and ecologists from New Jersey to Maine. And as a result, we have gathered a unique collection of information, including many success stories from your peers in this region.
The road mortality for our target species declined like precipitously.
I recognize that the species of concern are part of this overall ecosystem and contribute to a healthy ecosystem. And a healthy ecosystem helps flooding and helps water quality and helps all of the aspects of overall wellness of the area. So I think having wildlife crossings contributes to that.
This whole project, the Habitats and Highways filming and training, originated from our transportation agency partners. We've come to find out that just sharing information has been so valuable. You know, peer-to-peer exchange between transportation agencies, sharing best practices and information. So we're hoping that through projects like this, we can round up all of the amazing knowledge that already exists, you know, across the Northeast and borrow from elsewhere in the country and package it together and so that it's accessible for, you know, transportation agencies.
We hope this information will be useful to you in your efforts to sustain wildlife populations, maintain connectivity, and improve safety in your state. We are encouraged and excited by the many efforts we have observed in our travels, and we sincerely hope that the conversations and lessons learned in the following videos have the same impact on you and your colleagues. This Habitats and Highways training has been developed into these 5 modules that can be watched all at once or at your own pace. A sincere thank you to the many individuals and organizations that helped make this project possible.